stay with us. We have got Arunima and Payal also joining us on the broadcast, but we request all of you to please stay on with us. Let's first discuss what exactly the NDA meet is going to happen about. Now, the NDA meet is going to happen on a very crucial breakfast. NDA has very strategically divided all of their MPs, the newly elected one, in the group for this particular meeting, because the number game, of course, they are being extremely cautious about the number game despite of having the majority inside the lower house of the parliament. Now, the newly elected MPs are going to be trained on how exactly they are going to vote. Remember, this is the new parliament. A lot of technological advancements have already been in place. So this is why, not only about being cautious about the number, they are also going to be trained about how exactly they are going to cast vote in favor of their candidate. Prahlad Joshi, Union Minister, he is also going to be hosting the Karnataka MPs. Remember, as I said before, the MPs have been divided into different blocks. They are going to be meeting at different houses at the same time. All of them will be given the instructions in order to cast the vote in an unanimous format. Apart from Prahlad Joshi, what we are learning is that Sarbananda Sonowal is also hosting the Northeastern MPs. After that, we are also learning in Maharashtra. Now, the Maharashtra MPs are going to meet at Maharashtra Sadan, of course. They will be then given out the details about how exactly they are going to cast vote and who to cast their vote for. Andhra Pradesh MPs are going to meet at Ram Mohan Naidu's house. So, this is the NDA's strategy, what we have picked up from our sources. This is how they are going to be training all of their newly elected MPs about casting the vote, having an echo inside the lower house of the parliament. We have got CNN News 18's Payal Mehta also joining us on the broadcast. Payal, we heard Parliamentary Affairs Minister Kiran Rijiju giving out this statement that they are again going to reapproach the opposition in terms of having a consensus over the position of the Speaker inside the House. They clearly have the majority though. What exactly is their strategy in order to get the consensus from the opposition?
As far as the government strategy is concerned, it's very, very clear that they do not want a contest as far as the Lok Sabha Speaker's position is concerned. As far as keeping their own flock together, that's the reason, you know, mock drills are being done in these breakfast meetings to explain to the leaders. Because remember, Sakshi, this is a new parliament, in the sense this is a new 18th Lok Sabha, which is currently on as well. So obviously, since the seating arrangement has not been finalized yet, a lot of MPs have not been given their seat number. So that's why the voting through the machines cannot really happen. It has to be a physical voting, which means you will be given out voting slips and you will have to tick accordingly to see which one person you want to vote for. So there's of course a lot of host of new MPs who have no idea of how to do this. That's the reason the dummy voting slips were distributed to them last night. Explainers were done for them as to how to go about voting, because they do not want to see any vote which is going invalid. As far as the government strategy is concerned, in terms of the opposition, yesterday also Kiran Rijiju approached the opposition and told the opposition that it will be good for the democracy that, you know, we do not have an election for the Lok Sabha Speaker's post as well. But, you know, since K. Suresh has already been put up as a candidate, and since Sharin and Pallavi have been reporting that the opposition still wants an assurance from the government about the deputy speaker, then they will actually probably withdraw themselves. But we do not really know as to whether the government will still want to agree on a conditional approach. Yesterday, when Mr. Balu came to meet Rajnath Singh, we were there and we saw Rajnath Singh and Balu having a cordial discussion, and Balu had, in a way, agreed to the terms of the government. But, you know, with Mr. Venugopal coming in and saying that, you know, we need to make that decision right now on the post of Deputy Speaker, that was not acceptable to the government. The government said, you cannot, like, you know, arm twist us and hold us by the gun to actually give you a record. In a sense, you know, the government would have accommodated the opposition parties, is what we're given to understand. But conditional, support is something that the government did not really want. But, you know, as the onus to run the house and as the onus to conduct the parliament is the onus of the government once again wants to approach the opposition parties and tell them that let's elect the speaker, you know, unanimously, because the speaker is the custodian of the parliament, is the custodian of the house, and his election should not really happen, because, you know, like we've been reporting, this election is probably happening after 1976, which is close to 50 years, you know, ago, the last election for the Lok Sabha speaker happened.
Definitely. Payal, please stay with us. Arunima is also there with us on the broadcast. Arunima, if we were to talk about one of the statements doing rounds, it's that opposition is ruling in a couple of states. They have never asked for a deputy's position for the opposition in their ruled states. What is the word that you are picking up around this particular statement? Arunima, can you hear me?
Yes, Sakshi, can you repeat your question?
Yes, Arunima, I was asking, one of the statements which was doing round around this entire tussle over the deputy speaker's post is that Congress as well as their ally partners are ruling couple of states in our country as well. They have never given the deputy speaker's position to any of the opposition in their states.
Yes, that's what the Bharatiya Janata Party spokespersons have been pointing out, that if it is a norm that the speaker's position must go to the ruling side and the deputy speakers must go to the opposition, then why has that norm not been followed in various states? The Congress Party, you've heard all of them, be it Rahul Gandhi himself when he addressed the press yesterday or be it K.C. Venugopal, they are adamant that, you know, whatever the Bharatiya Janata Party might want to say, the fact is denial of the deputy speaker's position in 2019 was not with the Democratic traditions of parliament, and this time they want to set it correct. But before that happens, I also want to go across to these supporters of Om Birla who have come from Kota.
Yes, I am from Kota, and I want to say for something. Most of the opposition leaders also will vote for Om Birla because he lives in the heart of the Kota persons and India persons and even member of parliament of opposition.
जो आरोप लग रहे हैं कि पहली बार चुनाव होने जा रहा है स्पीकर के पोजीशन के लिए पिछले 50 साल में, आपको लगता है ये चुनाव आपके मतलब ओम बिरला जी के फेवर में ही जाएगा?
अरे आप निश्चित मानिए, इतने वोट मिलेंगे. आप देखते हैं पिछली बार उनकी जिस तरह से उन्होंने लोकसभा चलाई, विपक्षी भी उनके कायल थे.
कायल थे वो तो कह रहे हैं आपने 130 को सस्पेंड कर दिया.
नहीं नहीं, ऐसा नहीं है मैडम. आप देखेंगे आज, अगर आप देखेंगे तो इस बहुमत से वो जीतेंगे कि शायद विपक्षियों को उनका जवाब मिले.
सो दीस कोटा सपोर्टर्स, यू नो पीपल हु हैव कम फ्रॉम कोटा, सपोर्टर्स ऑफ ओम बिरला, दे हैव बीन स्ट्रीमिंग इन फ्रॉम अर्ली दिस मॉर्निंग, एंड व्हाटएवर द ऑपोजिशन माइट बी सेइंग अबाउट द डेप्यूटी स्पीकर्स पोजीशन, अबाउट द कंडीशनैलिटी इज अटैच्ड, these supporters are very confident that in the next hour or so Om Birla will once again be elected by the parliamentarians as the speaker of the house. We're expecting his family to leave from his residence shortly and go to parliament to witness Om Birla take the speaker's chair for the second time. He's meeting and greeting visitors since early this morning, and it's more or less certain as far as his supporters are concerned that Om Birla is coming back at that speaker's chair for a second term, irrespective of what the opposition might say about the elections, irrespective of K.G. Suresh being made to stand against Om Birla, and irrespective of the conditionalities attached as far as the deputy speaker's chair is concerned.
Definitely, and as one of the supporters standing right behind you also hinted at, and in fact we were picking up a lot of hints and statements coming in from the opposition that they are going to pour in their support for Om Birla. We'll keep coming back to you, Arunima, Pallavi and Payal. Thank you so much for walking us through all the latest developments that you have picked up so far. Shifting focus to a couple of more reactions coming in within the same story, let's take a look at all of those.
आज स्पीकर के पद पर प्रपोजल मूव करना था, तो उससे पहले माननीय राजनाथ सिंह जी, माननीय अमित शाह जी, विपक्ष के प्रमुख लोगों से बात की. लेकिन दुर्भाग्यपूर्ण बात यह है कि उन लोग को प्री कंडीशन लगा के, पूरा शर्त लगा के हम सपोर्ट करेंगे ऐसे बोल रहे हैं. संसदीय प्रजाप्रभुत्व में ऐसे कभी भी हो नहीं सकता है. तो जब विषय उठाया डिप्टी स्पीकर का, तब भी माननीय रक्षा मंत्री जी ने कहा कि जब उप स्पीकर का, डिप्टी स्पीकर का विषय आएगा तब हम फिर से सबसे चर्चा करेंगे, क्योंकि ये जो स्पीकर और डिप्टी स्पीकर पक्ष और विपक्ष का नहीं होता है.
Sir, today is a big day. Speaker election are on, but the numbers are not in your favor. So, few hours from now, just about an hour from now, the speaker election will begin. So, what is the point of this election? Why is it that K. Suresh had to file his nomination?
Opposition parties wanted a consensus, wanted a conversation, and the tradition of the parliament to be followed. We were open when the leader of the house, Mr. Rajnath Singh ji, reached out to Karge Sahib day before yesterday. For we were hopeful that they will come back to us and with the proposal that the speaker will be from the NDA and the India Alliance will have its deputy speaker. We were not insisting any name for the speakership. But because of their arrogance, Mr. Modi and Amit Shah's arrogance, they had forced this election on the India Alliance.
Is there some miscommunication between the India Alliance? Yesterday, we of course.